Moulardeuk, it's a mule. Muscovy daddy, Pekin mammy. Once they are out, they stay for 1 week under heat lamps. After the heat lamp, they go out in the field for around 9 weeks. Okay? They have to be 9 weeks outside. They go back and forth between the water and the food in the field. And the reason for that is because we want to build their legs, muscles in the legs. The legs have to be very strong because they're going to carry that huge, big liver in there. You have to realize this is around 15 pounds. They are being fed corn, and then after 9 weeks, which is when they are adult, they go inside and we force feed them for 2 to 3 weeks. Force feeding them means putting in a funnel, putting cooked corn in a funnel 2-3 times a day, and feeding them. It lasts exactly 5 seconds every time. After a couple of days, when they see the feeder coming, they actually go to the feeder. The first couple of days, they don't. Why don't they? Not because force feeding hurts, because it doesn't hurt. And we know that for a fact. We've done studies on the stress of duck when he's being force fed. The first couple of days, ducks get out of the way of the feeder because they are afraid of man. Man is a predator. Man is supposed to kill duck. This is what we do, okay? It's exactly the same way as a lion with the antelope. The antelope is not going to get near the lion, even if the lion say, come, come, I'm going to feed you. I don't trust you. Same with a man. Fat liver, foie gras, fat liver. That's where they store most of the calories. It's like a cockpit of calories. The second part where they store calories is the skin. You see this? You see the thickness of the skin on top of this? Okay, when you go look at a chicken or a guinea hen or a pheasant or any other poultry, this skin is much, much thinner than that. Ducks and geese need that thick skin because of that flight at high altitude where it is very, very cold. That's why when they eat, they force feed themselves before migration. They store calories in the skin to be acting as an insulation. And in the liver.